Welcome to EPG Patashala. I am Yepu Shadri, Assistant Professor, College of Food Science and Technology, Professor Jay Shankar, Telangana State Agricultural University, Hyderabad. Today we are going to discuss about microwave heating in food processing applications. So in this microwave heating in food processing application, what do you mean by microwave heating and what are the applications in food industry and where we can use, what are the advantages and disadvantages of microwave heating, we'll discuss in this chapter one by one. Okay, so before going into detail into microwave heating, earlier we have a processing technologies like thermal processing, heat processing. In heat processing, what we are doing, we are cooking, we are making the raw materials into softening, or we are converting the raw material into palatable food items. That means we will improving the organoleptic or sensory characteristics of the food, and we will improve the nutritional properties of the food. And so that means we are making the raw materials into a palatable form, that means eatable form. So that is the general thermal processing. And after Nicholas Appert, who invented the process of canning, then thermal applications, when you use high temperatures for pasteurization and sterilization, what happens apart from this desired qualities, what do you mean desired qualities? Means one is the cooking and softening of the material and bringing the desirable flavor and texture, color in the product. Apart from that, that excess heating or there may be chances of a few vital components which are heat sensitive, they may be lost during processing. So that means in thermal processing process or direct thermal processing process, in process there may be chances of losing of vital heat sensitive materials. So that means there is a problem with this thermal processing system. Then scientists are looking for alternatives. Then they found this microwave heating is one kind of alternative where we can minimize the loss of these vital nutrients during the process. Apart from this vital desired changes, means the cooking, softening, bringing desired flavor, color, texture. Apart from that also, it will preserve the, minimize the loss of vital nutrients in that process. So that's why, so we are using the microwave heating in our different applications. And now we are using this microwave. So what do you mean by microwave heating? So microwave heating refers to a dielectric heating due to polarization effects at a selected band of frequency in a non-conducting materials. That means, so here we are using a selected frequency of wavelengths for the pasteurization or sterilization of the or heating of the food material. Generally in food application we use a microwave frequency of 915 megahertz or 2450 megahertz. This is the most commonly used frequency, but you can use a frequency from 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. In that frequency also we can use, and sometimes if you use excess frequency or it may combine with other telecommunication frequencies, then there may be damage to that. So for that reason, so mostly in for food application we prefer around 915 megahertz to 2450 megahertz. You can see in the slide picture of this how at what wavelength we are using for food applications. Some 300 megahertz to 3000 gigahertz, you can see how the microwave heating MW, so that means microwave heating. So in that microwave heating we use for the food applications. So when we are using this microwave heating, the penetration powers. So penetration at 915 megahertz, the penetration is different, and 2450 megahertz penetration of this microwave heating inside the food is different. So when you use the microwave heating, so uniformly the complete product will be heated up, and uniformly heat transfer takes place, and the uniform quality will have end of this microwave heating. So now in the picture you can see how this microwave heating system, what are the components are present. So as we know, microwave heating is a closed system. In that magnetron is present, that inside magnetron, here you can see in the picture very clear, there is anode, cathode, and magnets, and microwave radiation, how these radiations are emitting from that, and what is the role of magnet and the cooling fins and ceramic magnet, how this radiation is evolving from that magnetron. So that you can see in this picture very clearly. With color you can see anode, cathode, microwave radiation, magnet, output antenna and ceramic cooling pins. These are the components inside the magnetron. So from the magnetron, this frequency is passed through the food and food get heated up because of the frictional magnetic resonance and friction, molecular frictions, then it start developing heating. So then in microwave heating is what we see in our home, that is microwave heating, or in other any shop you will see microwave heating is a simple box where you are keeping the food. But that same setup is not applicable for the large scale food industry. So for example, if you want to use this microwave heating for heating of some foods or some particular food items, so in that case we need to have a big setup. The setup you can see in this picture very clearly, the microwave heating equipment. So here the generator, from this magnetron generator, the electron, this frequency of 2450 megahertz frequency waves are producing, and these waves are passing through the waveguide, and it is fixed to the conveyor belt, conveyor where on which the product is passing from one section to another section, and during that time and these waves are passed through the product and product get heated up, and it involves, that means a pasteurization or a sterilization or a general heating or maybe a blanching or maybe a cooling. So anything can be done with this heating application system. So in this another picture you can see very clear picture with full diagram, and you can hear the fellow is cooking the meat patties, the product prepared from the meat patties. So that is minced meat patties. So how these minced meat patties are drying or sterilizing with the help of microwave heating, and patties are passing over the conveyor, and through the door the quality control person is checking the product. In the picture you can see very clear that a hot product is coming out of from the microwave box. And another one is the radio heating frequency. In radio heating frequency, because of this oscillation and applications, this radiation is passing through the food, and it because of frictional movement or the exciting of the electrons in the food, and it get excited and then it reach to higher stage and heat is generating. So because of that heat, food get heated up and food undergoes sterilization or pasteurization or cooking. Then we have a palatable product end of the heating or a cooling system. So and in other of some food applications, especially in this picture you can see how this chips, for example potato kind of chips are there. So chips, you prepared a chip but it has some amount of moisture. If you use conventional drying system for drying of the chips, what happens if you eat it excess heating, then the sugars present in the chips get caramelized and the color of your chips products will be changed from desired color to the light brown color. That means there is a chance of browning effect. So in conventional heating system, in conventional drying system, in case of chips there is a problem of browning. When you use a microwave heating for drying up that time, so there is no question of this browning. So here the browning will not take place and the food is in whatever the desired color we are required by the consumer or required by the industry ingredients. So that means the color is preserved and the texture is preserved and the quality is preserved when you use microwave heating. So that is the advantage with the microwave heating. So that means we can save the vital minerals or vital nutrients, vital components in the food by heating through the microwave heating than the conventional heating system. So here in the picture you can see how these chips are heating up through this microwave heating. There is a kind of exhaust box kind of thing, and from that the product is passing, and then because of this microwaves and the product get heated up at 2450 megahertz or at 915 megahertz. So when you see inside how this magnetron inside, how this microwave cavity or system, how the power generator, the multi-mode system, how they appears inside, so you can see in this picture. And in this microwave heating and dielectric heating, so we are making using of dielectric properties of the polar solvent. Here the water is a polar solvent, it has dielectric properties, so we using dielectric properties by exposing to a specific frequency bond in a non-conducting material. So that's why we use for cooking purpose or heating of the food material in microwave heating, we use either glass bowls or some certain materials only allowed. We cannot use whatever the material you want to use in microwave heating. So we use glass bowl, ceramic things only we are using for the heating of food materials in microwave heating system. So when you see the how much these microwaves are penetrating into the food. For example, if a product called a cheese sauce is prepared, when you heat the product when it is in 20 degrees Celsius temperature product, and when you pump this microwave heating, then the product, the penetration power at 27 megahertz, in the table you can see the 35.5 centimeters, the penetration power is there when you use at 20 degrees Celsius at 27 megahertz. When it is 915 megahertz, the penetration depth is 8.2. When it is 2450 megahertz, the penetration depth is less. So that means when the frequency is changing from 27 megahertz to 2450 megahertz, the penetration depth is decreasing. So in case of 27, the penetration depth is 35.5 centimeters, whereas in 2450 megahertz, the penetration depth is only 4.6 centimeters. That means the penetration depth is, then if you use high frequency, the penetration power is decreasing. And similarly, when you use 80 degree Celsius, when you want to achieve the temperature of the product, cheese sauce at 80 degree Celsius, that means again the penetration power is further decreasing. When you are heating a cheese sauce at 121 degree Celsius at 27 megahertz or 915 megahertz or 2450 megahertz, and further penetration power is decreasing from 19.1 to 2.1 in 2450 megahertz frequency. So similarly, in case of macaroni and cheese, the other studies conducted with the macaroni and cheese, when 20 degree Celsius, again the penetration power is decreasing. So penetration is proportional to the inversely proportional to the frequency which you use in the microwave heating. So then microwave heating, first in the company in French, they developed a NutriPack. So this is the pack which contain a valve pack. Valve pack is the trademark of a French company, the NutriPack solution. NutriPack solution is the company. They developed a valve pack. Okay, valve pack is a product where a product is packed in a packet, and that packet can be heated in microwave heating without opening that packet. That means as such packet, you can put it in the microwave system and the product get heated without affecting on its pressures. So that means here the wall is surrounded around the packet. That wall is having a adhesive and installed on upper part. That means it is a kind of heat sealing film cover. So that means inside it get heated up, and when you cool it and it get cooled up. So you no need to open that pack. So such a wall packs developed by this NutriPack company located in France. So in this, the pressure they used for opening up this pack, 10 millibar to 5 millibar. And when you look at the advantages of microwave heating, so the microwave heating can be used successfully for heating, drying, sterilized with the sterilization of other products. And when compared with this microwave heating, when we use for this product, any food item, when compared with the conventional drying or conventional thermal application, so this microwave heating has more advantages, because here the loss of nutrients is less, and heat sensitive material get preserved in this material. That's why microwave cooking material is more, and moreover the penetration is good. So that means uniform heat is passed through the complete food material, and each and every particle or each and every component of the food get heated up uniformly, and you have a uniform quality, uniform tasty product. So and all the nutrients get preserved, and flavors and organoleptic quality or sensorial qualities of the product get preserved in this microwave heating system. And this In, for example, when you look at the ultra pasteurization or ultra UHT processing, in that process, so heat labile nutrients get lost. So that means even you can heat your product at 121 degrees Celsius, and though you can minimize the losses in the sample, that is also advantage. And moreover, there is no fouling effects. For example, in heat processing, high steam, when you are using high steam, there is a deposition on the machine parts, there is a deposition or there is a condensation, there is a problem of scaling, there is a problem of fouling in the machine. So in this, absolutely in microwave heating, you won't see such kind of fouling problem or deformation or any depositions inside the machine or on the packet is absolutely free from the fouling problems in the microwave heating system. And the overall heat efficiency is around 80%. So in case of thermal heating process, the heat may be lost in the atmosphere, the heat may be lost during pumping, or heat may be lost during processing, or heat may be lost during handling. So here the heat losses are less, and the energy saving and cost energy saving when compared to thermal. So here we can save the energy. And this is also another advantages with this. And in case of, for example, if it is a milk processing industry is there, their CIP, clean in place, is a problem. For example, after one day or second day after using the machine, generally they clean the machines with the CIP process. That means they use hot water, acid water, alkali water, and they clean all their equipments by name called CIP. So by pumping at different proportionate, different alkali ratios, different acid ratio, they clean cold water, hot water rinsing. So that means to keep the food contact surfaces or to keep the premises clean, and they use CIP. So in microwave heating system also, the cleaning is absolutely easy, and you can clean very well easily, and there is no problem of CIP. And even it is suitable for in case of liquid foods where viscosity is more, the heat transfer is difficult, pumping of the material through the pipes or through the machineries is difficult. In case of microwave heating system, those problems are less, and you can easily apply to viscous materials, you can easily apply to high heat sensitive materials, and even you can apply to multi-phase fluids also. So that is the advantage with the microwave heating system. And the maintenance point of view, in conventional drying system or conventional heating mechanism, where you have to invest a lot of money for the maintenance. So in this case, the maintenance is very less. And here in microwave heating is silent, no noise. So that means no exhaust gases or exhaust flues. In conventional heating system, if it is a heating mechanism is there, a boiler is there, then from the boiler, if it is a fire tube boiler, lot of smoke, lot of fumes are coming from that boiler, then a lot of exhaust gases are releasing to the atmosphere. So that problem will not be there in case of microwave heating. It can also combine with other technologies like heat exchangers and infrared heating for better performance. Even you can use combine, and combine means you can use a slight pasteurization temperature with other fluid, other heat exchanging system, and you can use microwave heating, and you can get the better quality in the final product. Here microwave heating you can use for n number of products. You can use fruits and vegetables, you can use for milk, you can use for meat, you can use for chips, you can use for chocolates, you can use for cooking of sausages, dry items, non-veg items, or bread, biscuits, cakes, and blanching of vegetables, heating. And for that, you can see in that picture very clearly all that example products which are cooked in this microwave heating. And commercialization of microwave heating in the baking industry is maximum possible, and when compared to other industry, in baking industry you can easily apply this microwave heating for baking of cakes, for baking of muffins or donuts. So for that reason you can use this microwave heating, when you use microwave heating for baking. So that's why you might have seen in when you go to bakery, you might have seen microwave heating. So microwave heating is a common equipment in a bakery industry. So you can, even in large scale also, you can apply this microwave heating for the baking industry. And you can see this another radio frequency finished drying of bakery products. In this picture, you can see very clear how this radio frequency is used in this process. In this process, first the product is baked at 2450 megahertz. In that high frequency, they generally use. And during when you use this radio frequency baking system, and you can reduce the energy around 50%. Radio frequency, sir, for example, when you use radio frequency for baked items or for the baking industry, there you can eliminate maximum problems in the baking industry. So that can be done with the help of this system. And even you can use this system. Some scientists found that you can use even radio frequency systems for frying of the food items, for chips kind of products, or for namkins kind of products also. You can see in the big biscuits how radio frequency baked biscuits. So absolutely the product is free from all the defects or damages. And you can see other products like sponge products, like reduced when you use this microwave heating for sponge products like bread, cakes. So it will reduce the mold spores, the mold fungus molds, and it also increases shelf life and increases the production. That production output it also increases with this microwave heating. And this radio frequency drying of bakery products generally used for appetizer snacks, margarines, puff pastry, breakfast cereals, bread croutons, sponge product, frizzle, shortbread. So you can see all these products, even you can use for drying up pasta, vermicelli also. So these products can, so the microwave heating can be applied for these products, and you can sterilize or you can cook, like what you use for conventional heating system. Similarly, we can use this microwave heating for the these products. So here when you use this, what I call, in picture you can see conventional retorting. So for example, a product, when you use conventional retorting on the product, in this bread you can see, so that the outer one, the product which is baked under the conventional heating system, the appearance, and when the product is baked under the general system, you will have the very clear cut quality difference between conventionally cooked product as well as the microwave cooked product. So microwave cooked product, its appearance and its ergonomic properties are properties are highly good in case of this microwave heating when compared to with the non-microwave heating systems. And sometimes in microwave heating system, meals, for example, meal trays. So for example, Cryovac is the company, is an Australian based company. In that Cryovac company, what they do, they may prepare a meals. The tray, kind of a tray like our Indian, South Indian thali, North Indian thali, where we place different curries, chapatis, food items in a different shelves kind of thing. So similarly, they prepared this cryovac system in that they have a meal of complete meal. That means there you have rice, you have other dal, curry, chutney, other items in a tray. So in that tray, so as such you can use the tray for cooking of that product. And whenever you want to eat that product, you can use that one. So that means a single tray can be used for the cooking or for the warming up that product. As like, you, for example, when you go to bakery, you want to have a puff. That means that puff is, when you touch that puff is very cold. So to heat it for some time, what the fellow do, they keep that bread in or the puff inside the microwave heating, and then we'll have the what you call hot puff. So similarly, the meals also, even the meat kind of trays also developed. That conventionally the tray can cook inside the microwave system. Then so it will be useful. A single tray can serve your cooking purpose as well as for heating of that products. So you can see that picture very clearly in the dome, how these trays are fixing inside. So here you can see other picture. So pilot scale sterilization system, where they are using this 10 kV pilot scale sterilization for the production of microwave heating. So they are using this 915 megahertz single mode 10 kilowatt pilot scale sterilization system for different food applications in other parts of the world. So this machine, and you can see how these boxes are looking, and how these radio frequency waves are pumping to that boxes. You can see very clearly all the machine parts. That exhaust box is there, and that wave pumping system is there, and they are recording the temperatures and the wavelengths of that product. And here you can see in this picture very clear the egg pour two. Egg pour two means a egg which is after breaking the egg, we are cooking in a pan, is called egg pour two. Okay, the egg pour two prepared in microwave oven, the egg pour two prepared in retort sterilization system, the egg pour two prepared in untreated sample without any treatment, without a general other conventional system. So when after cooking three different samples from three different methods, when you compare this, so you see the color changes. So how beautifully this microwave cooked product is looking when compared to retort sterilization or untreated sample. So this microwave heating is looking very very appealing, and color and its appearance is very good when compared to retort sterilization or untreated samples. Okay, so that means the texture and the quality, appearance and sensorial properties, and the minimizing the loss of vital nutrients or sensitive nutrients, or preserving of sensitive nutrients are more in case of microwave heating. So by looking at this, you can understand that how microwave heating is useful over the other heating systems. And here mashed potato, you can see in this picture. So after boiling, potato is boiled in microwave heating system, conventional heating system, or other normal regular cooking system. So after mashing, so mashing means after cooking, we are mixing together, we are making mashing means, okay, we are breaking all the what you call tubers into a paste kind of thing. So when you see the mashed potato of these three samples in this picture, you can see the conventionally, as I said, so when you use excess heating, what happens, the sugars present in the potato get caramelized, or heating, or maybe because of caramelization, they undergo browning. So the potatoes cooked under conventional retort are in light brown color. You can see in that picture. Whereas the microwave cooked product is clear white in color. And whereas the control sample also having light, general normal domestic cooking methods, if you see that, then here also you will see a light changes in the color. So that means the quality of the potato cooked under microwave heating is better than the quality of the conventionally retort cooked or general control method systems. So with the help of microwave heating, so microwave energy has advantages over conventional heating systems, and microwave heating can be used for sterilization application, pasteurization application, heating applications and cooking application, and it minimizes the loss of what you call heat sensitive, and it can be used even for milk and juice kind of processing plants, and you can use for ready to eat meals kind of products. But 100% replacement of conventional heating with microwave heating is not possible, because microwave heating has certain limitations here also, for example, in microwave heating, what happens, how this heat is transferring, how this heat is forming, and the volume of the food, or if the thickness of the food is more, then penetration again is a problem. So that means sometimes when the food is in bulk, or when we are drying the food, that time if the drying, the thickness of the drying layer is more, then the uniform drying may not take place in this microwave heating when compared to the conventional heating. So that's why it is not 100% alternative to the conventional heating system, but it has certain advantages over the conventional heating system, but it cannot replace the 100% microwave heating, 100% conventional heating systems. And preparing of a pilot plant or commercial microwave heating system is highly difficult. So designing or using of a big size microwave heating system for a big scale or a large scale industry is not possible, and it is cost effective and when compared to the conventional heating system. And so far the success rate with the commercial microwave heating is not much in the present context. So still research is going on, and it may not be suitable for all the foods. So for that reason, commercial it is not successful so far. So scientists are working for developing this microwave heating as a better alternative for the conventional heating system. So at the end of the conclusion, what I would like to say is this microwave heating is the one of the best where you can preserve the heat sensitive material, nutrients, and it can be applied for very well for the baking industry or for the some chips kind of industry, some potato based products industry. It is well and good, but in case of drying of grains or heating of grains or heating of milk, heating of juice in a large scale, it is not suitable when compared to the conventional heating system. So if you have any doubts in this, and you can refer the e-text from the site, or you can go through different journals, Journal of Food Engineering, Journal of Food Properties, and other electromagnetic radiations. So if you go through that, and you'll better understand about these processes. Thank you.